The 110-year-old Horns Ferry Bridge crashed into the Des Moines River about 10:30 Saturday night. An historic landmark turned into a twisted, rusty heap of metal and wood. The spectacular sight gave hundreds of Labor Day campers an extra treat during what would normally be a quiet weekend vacation. It also gave two teenagers the scare of their lives.
My boyfriend wanted to go farther towards the exact middle, but if we would have, I'm not sure where we would have been.
You think you're pretty lucky?
Yeah, very lucky.
It was a scary feeling. I thought it was just a practical joke. You know, I thought somebody was just banging on it with a bat or something. And then when it started getting louder and louder, we took off for the end. Didn't know if we were going to make it.
So you did make it, but how close were you, do you think, to before it actually fell?
Oh, by the time we got off the bridge, it had stopped rumbling. So it probably fell while we were on it.
Marion County authorities closed the bridge to auto traffic back in 1982 and then to pedestrian and bikers in 89. Since then, historians have worked to restore the bridge and place it on the National Register of Historic Places, but it appears they were too late.
I was disappointed, but I was also not surprised. I wasn't surprised because I've looked at it and it was pretty awful.
The bridge may look demolished, but Marion County preservationists say they're not giving up yet. It would cost about $300,000 to restore the bridge, but now that the bridge is down, that price tag will probably go up. Near Lake Red Rock, Todd Magel, TV 8 News.